The last algorithm that we are going to discuss is called the partial differences method. Now, the partial differences method is a lot different than the other algorithms that we have looked at. We are actually going to start with the hundreds column, and in the hundreds column, we have a 5 and a 4, and this 5 is actually 500, and this 4 is actually 400. So we are going to set up a problem down here where we are just going to subtract the 500 and the 400. So we have 500 take away 400, and that equals, we are going to put a positive 100, and I will explain that positive in just a minute. So now we're going to look at the tens column, and in the tens column we have an 8, which stands for 80, and this 9, which stands for 90. And we are actually going to flip those two numbers and set up a subtraction problem down here where the 90 is first. So it's going to be 90 take away 80. And because we flipped those numbers, instead of having a positive answer, we are going to have a negative answer. So 90 take away 80 is 10. And we have a negative 10 again because we flipped them. Now we are going to go to the ones column, and in the ones column we have a 4 and a 6. And just like we did with the tens column, we are going to flip those numbers. So we have a 6 take away 4, and because we flipped them, our answer is going to be a negative 2, because 6 take away 4 is 2. And now we are going to solve those problems, or this subtraction problem over here. And we are going to start with this 100. 100 take away 10 is 90. 90 take away 2 is 88. So the answer to our original problem of 584 take away 496 is 88. The last problem that we are going to solve using the partial differences method is 612 take away 186. Now remember, with the partial differences method, we start in the hundreds column. We have a 6, which stands for 600, and a 1, which is 100. And we are going to write our subtraction problem here. So we're going to have 600 take away 100. And since we didn't have to flip any of those numbers around, our answer is going to be a positive 500, because 600 take away 100 is 500. So we have a positive 500. Now let's look at the tens column. And we have a 1, which is going to be 10, and an 8, which is 80. But because the 8 is at the bottom and we need to set up a subtraction problem for our partial differences method, we are going to flip them. So we are going to start with the 8, which is 80. So we're going to start with 80 and take away 10. And because we flipped them, our answer is going to be a negative 70. And our last number we are going to get from the ones column, and we have a 2 and a 6, but since the bigger number is at the bottom, we are going to flip them, and we are going to start with 6 take away 2, and because we flipped them, our answer is going to be a negative 4. So let's solve our subtraction problem. 500 take away 70 is 430. 430 take away 4 is 426. And that is how you do the partial differences method.